Yeah, this attack put dozens of people in danger. There were tiny kids and plenty of other people right back here at this basketball court in the middle of the day when someone pulled out a gun and started spraying bullets.
The fight on this McKeesport basketball court put about a dozen children in the path of bullets, and many residents here worry soon one of their own kids could be the victim.
And it's the children that are the suffering.
And I'm afraid of my four-year-old son being out here and a bullet hits him.
This afternoon's attack came shortly before 3 o'clock when a group of young men were playing basketball on the court in Crawford Village. For some reason, some of those people started arguing, then one of them opened fire.
I was playing with my son in the yard, and that's whenever all the shots was fired.
This man, who doesn't want us to show his face on TV, says he could tell something bad was going to happen, so he hurried to get 10 or more kids playing outside to safety.
All kinds of arguments, and then shots was fired, and then I was getting all the kids, putting them in the house.
None of those kids was hurt, but one man at the court was hit. Witnesses say he ran into a nearby apartment and collapsed on the floor. He'd been shot 4 times, including twice in the back. Witnesses say he was able to speak, but was in severe pain. Now, this attack comes less than a week after another shooting in Crawford Village. 59-year-old jitney driver John Haas was killed here on Wednesday. Residents say the shootings are becoming almost routine, and they worry that even police can't stop the violence.
We got patrols, they come up here, but as soon as they know they're not here, then this is what happens.
Well, the victim of this shooting was rushed to the hospital, and police still have not caught the shooters. Reporting live in McKeesport, Bob Hazen, Channel 4 Action News.